notepad. And as you can see, what I'm looking for here is I'm looking for anything that looks as though, any entries that look as though they're untoward. For example, if I also have a curvature there of say 0.02 or 0.002, as you can see here, we're virtually along a straight, so that's a very quick sanity check I like to do. Another sanity check that I like to do is I like to go to circuit, edit variable grip factors, and I'll basically import the curvature file just to make sure that it hasn't done anything particularly weird. And as we can see, we've got a circuit that looks it looks very similar to what we've just seen in our data. Okay, that's basically how we generate a curvature file. Let's talk about how we would go about generating a bump profile. To generate a bump profile, we go to simulate bump profile modeling. Once again, we're going to import our monster file, and once again, if I was to have strain gauges, I click here first, then I click on the add monster file. But since I don't have strains, I don't need to worry about that, so I'll click here to add the monster import file. I'll navigate back to where I had I'll click back to where I had my monster import file, which is in my monster example. And what I'll do here is I'll simply click on the tab that says create bump profile, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill out these relative particulars. Now here I put in my damper sampling period, which is obviously 50 hertz or 0.02 of a second. Damper scaling factors front and rear, I leave that as one for the time. I'll leave that as one for the time being. Obviously, this isn't running a monoshock, so I leave that as zero. Here, maximum bump rate. Now, what this maximum bump rate is this is basically a filter for you to filter out any erroneous data. Now, as a rough rule of thumb, when you're doing if you're doing open wheelers, which this car is, I like to stick my maximum bump rate at about 0.2 meters per second or about 200 millimeters per second. If this was something like, say, a V8 supercar or a NASCAR, I'd be putting in, say, about 0.3 or 0.4. But as you get more experienced with doing this, you'll come up with your own metrics about how to do this. But this is a good start point. Now, these dampers were zeroed on the ground, so I'll indicate that, one, they're zeroed on the ground. This Karman filter R value, typically this is best left at the default value that you see there, but it's another way of just sort of nicely filtering out, taking out any unwanted spikes. And you can see here that I'll specify my max bump value and my max droop value. This is just as a safety to ensure that the car doesn't do anything particular, that the bump profile algorithm doesn't do anything silly. For the time being, I'm going to set these bump limits at about 20 mil in bump and 20 mil in droop. You'll note that I keep these both as positive. So click on OK. That's ready to go. Now, to create the bump profile, what I need to do now is I need to run it through the numerical model. So I'll just click on Start, and I'll go to Start Simulation. Now, as this is going through its process, let me walk you through what's going on here. What we're doing is that the bump profile is going to be created in the same directory as the currently loaded ChassisSim car file. And what we're going to do is we're going to create a profile called bump_profile.nat. Now, what this is basically going to be is it's going to be a plot of all four road surface variation versus track distance. Now, what we've done here is that you'll notice on the previous dialogue, I left a checkbox called use specified 7-place grid files. If I leave this blank, what this is now doing is this is basically running the car through a 7-post rig analysis to come up with a frequency response. And so what's going to happen here is we're doing this for heave, pitch, and roll. And what's going to happen is that once these files are generated, what's going to happen is that we'll go through and do a frequency-based analysis. And as you can see, we've just come up with our bump profile. And to show you basically where that bump profile has been created, as you can see here, this is what we've just created. Now, as a sanity check, I like to basically open that up with Notepad, just to make sure that it hasn't done anything silly. What I'm looking for is I'm looking if I'll know if it's done something very silly if these are basically maxed out at the drip. But as you can see here, this looks quite reasonable. Now, for those of you with either Excel or MATLAB, another sanity check is to plot this in an Excel or MATLAB. But for the time being, I'm just going to let that go. So, and typically, what I'll do now is I'll just rename this as bump underscore profile Sebring demo. So, I've now generated a curvature file. I've now generated a bump profile. Let's now talk about how we would go through and basically now load this up. So to do that, we go to circuit data, we go to curvature file, and we just navigate to basically the directory that we've put in our new curvature file in. Okay, this is my curvature file, track Sebring demo. Now I'm going to load in my bump profile. Now, I save my bump profiles as star.dat and my curvature files as star.txt. Now, they're both ASCII files, but the reason I use these two file delimiters is to make sure I don't mix up my bump profiles and my curvature files. So I'll choose star.dat, and I'll choose the file we just created, bump profile Sebring demo. Okay, so we've now got our files good that are ready to go. And just to show you what they look like, we've got track Sebring demo, and we've got our bump profile. So we click on OK. Now, what we need to do is just a little bit of housekeeping before we do our initial simulation. We go back to bump profile modeling, and we click off create bump profile. While that tab is on, ChassisSim will always look for that to generate a bump profile. So unless you have any, unless you have a real, you have a real desire to redo your bump profile, once you've done the bump profile, go back to bump profile and turn this off. And as we were discussing before, if you wanted to use your heave, pitch, roll, and speed bone plot files pre-generated, you could go to here, but I would suggest for the time being, you would always leave that unchecked. Okay, so we'll just click on OK to apply that. Now we're ready to run our simulation. So we just simply click on the Start button, we click on Start Simulation, and basically, away we go. So